Welcome to the 2018 WBA Ontario Ranking Championship intro video and rules video. We're going to discuss pretty much everything that you need to know in this video to help you get ready for the 2018 WBA Ontario Ranking Championship, also known as the OVC. So, the tournament is Saturday, May 26th at the Port Hope Rec Centre in Port Hope, Ontario, Canada. You must register by April 26, 2018 to make sure that you're registered and you have pre-ordered all your break material. That includes your wood and your concrete for all your divisions. Now, what divisions do we have? We have various divisions. We have our 7-under division, we have our 8 to 12 year old division, our 13 to 17 year old division, and 18 plus. We further divide our division up by beginner intermediate and advanced flex level, as well as male and female competitors. We also have first time breakers for people that want to just try breaking but they're not quite sure yet. We have a division for that as well. Now, starting with the first time breaker division, first-time breaker that wants to just do the first-time breaker division, which is only one, they're only allowed to do that division. You get three boards, you can break the boards however way you want, and you can sort on that. Now, somebody that either a more advanced breaker or experienced breaker, or just wants to not do the first-time breaker and wants to compete in various other divisions, we have that. So we're going to discuss those. We have your power hand wood, power hand elbow wood, power foot wood. So, no three divisions. Power hand wood. You're allowed to use any hand technique, whether it be a punch, hammer fist, knife hand, wrist hand, palm strike, or any other type of hand strike that does not include a forearm. Power elbow wood includes drop elbow or overhand elbow. And then the power wood foot includes either like an axe kick or a heel stop of some sort. And any of those divisions, we pre-stack our wood before the division. So when you arrive at the tournament, you're going to pre-stack them. And how you would pre-stack them is you take one board, take carpenter pencil, which we provide, but you should also bring your own as well. You know, take your first board, put two pencil faces on the edge. Take a second board, on top. Put two more, put the third. You're going to keep filling that stack until you get them. So if you're going to break 10 boards, you're going to have a stack of 10 with pencil faces in between. Now you're going to take a piece of masking tape or tailor tape, and in the middle of that stack, you're going to do one loop, and you're going to put a tab on top so that when the judge takes the tape off, it's just much easier. So that goes for your power hand, your power elbow, and your power foot, all of the wood divisions. Now, power concrete divisions, we have power hand, elbow, and foot. Once again, same rules apply for what technique you allow, only breaking concrete. But you do not have to pre-stack, because it's way too hard to pre-stack concrete, because it gets very heavy very quickly. And our setup time are 5 minutes for either of those divisions. But because of pre-stacking in the wood division, setup only lasts a few seconds. How you would set up, after you have your free stack for the wood, you would set up your stand. Everybody sets up their stand. And when the judge is saying go, you would literally just have to put your wood on the stack, boom, you're done. Now, as far as concrete, when you would set up your stand, when the judge tells you to start stacking, you would stack your wood, your concrete, and then you would tell your judge when you're done. And we do have penalties for if you go over time, which you can read in the rule provided. We also have more creative multi-directional wood and creative open breaking. Your creative multi-directional wood is all wood board, mainly pine board. Your 8x12 or 8x10 or, you know, a center of height based on the size, 1 inch, 1/2 inch, 1/4 inch based on the age, and you're going to break. You're going to set up 4 stations. If you're beginner intermediate, if you're advanced black belt, you'll set up 8 stations. Now you can use stand, you can use human holders, you can self hold, but you know, 4 or 8 states, depending on your rank, you'll be judged on many different categories as creativity, power, focus, intensity, overall impression, the amount of material, etc. Creative also, you're allowed to break any type of material, including wood, baseball bat, concrete, tile, ice, whatever you can think of breaking. Definitely you cannot use glass or fire, because we have to consider the safety of the competitor and the spectator. And we want to make sure that we're as safe as possible. Now, Creative Wood has a 3-minute setup, time limit for setup, break, and cleanup. The Creative Open has 6-minute time limit to setup, break, and cleanup. So make sure you have lots of helpers to help you set up, clean up, and move your material. Then we also have our speed forward breaking. It's unspaced forward. So everyone can break both forward in 10 seconds in their respective division. Breaking unspaced forward when you set up 5 stations on the concrete stand, and you can use any type of technique, whether it be hand technique, elbow, foot stomp, whatever, you break as many as you can in 10 seconds. You'll have 2 human feeders that will keep bringing the material onto the stand as fast as they can to help you. And you only have 10 seconds as many as you can. And then we have different age categories and ranks for that. Power wood kicking is unspaced wood, once again, for our adult competitors, where you're going to be breaking a stack of wood in a horizontal fashion, whether it be a side kick or a back kick or a roundhouse, any type of sideways style kicking technique. Unspaced forward, you have 2 stacks, floor breaks, low floor, and a single strike win. We also have your high jump board breaking, where we use quarter-inch board in a machine that puts the board over your head. Whoever can jump the highest over their head level and break the board wins. You have 3 tries to get as high as you can. So that's the gist of our breaking. We also have a few world records that will be going on during the tournament. So that can be exciting as well. Now, let's go back to your pre-staffing wood. We ask that all competitors arrive at 8 a.m. to pre-stack the wood. This helps the tournament run much faster and make sure that you have less stress when you're trying to fill up the material. And again, all material for power division, high jump, speed breaking, etc. have to be ordered through up. The reason why we do this, that way all the competitors have reasonably the same material. That way we don't have one competitor with this type of material and another competitor with another type of material that are not the same. We want to unify all the material in the WBA. Even when we do competition records, which I'll discuss in a minute, we need to have the same material, so it's the same. I mean, it can't be a competition record or we can't have a world record if people are doing the different material. It's not the same, you know, it doesn't count, right? So, here's another thing. Now, all WBA members have the option of voting for competition records during the competition. So, if you're a WBA member and you break the current record, you'll become the new record holder. But if you're not a WBA member and you break the record, it doesn't count. So, if you are aiming to go for some record, make sure you are a WBA member. You can register at the WBA website or contact me and I'll help you with that. World records are separate from competition records. World records occur outside of competition records. So make sure you don't get those two mixed up. So at the WBA Ontario Breaking Championship, we will be having a few world records. But then anybody that's a WBA member will have the opportunity to go for competition records in their competition divisions. Any WBA member that's competing at our tournament will receive the following points. For first place, they'll receive 3 points. For second place, they'll receive 2.5 points. And for a third place win, they'll receive 2 points on the world national circuit. So So if you make points, you need to be a member of the WBA. You can go on the website, register, or contact me, and we will hook you up with that. And all competitors should have their own pencil, even though we have a bunch. It's much easier. Everybody has their own pencil. They have their own tape. But, you know, you're not a mix of people trying to get stuff. I don't have enough, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Also, this year we're going to have 5-foot Grand Championship trophies. We have 5 of them. We have our 7-under power wood, our 8-12 power wood, 13-7 power wood, 18-over power wood, and our 18-over power concrete. So you need to enter all 3 of the power wood division or concrete division according to your age category if you want to go and try to win the power concrete grand championship or power wood grand championship. So how we're going to do this is whoever breaks the wood board and power hand, wood, and elbow, like an accumulation of all 3, will win the grand championship. So if a competitor breaks 10-10-10, equal a total of 30 boards, and then competitor B breaks 10-9-13, they would win if they broke 32 boards, or competitor A would broke 30. Right? So that's accumulation of 3 breaks. Total board broken. Not total board set up, total board broken. So total board not broken does not factor into it. Total board broken will be the factor, not unbroken. So that's really awesome. Again, we have our couple world records that will be going on. Again, competitors will have opportunity for a competition record. And we also have our community living student will be breaking as well. We have all kinds of stuff going on this year at the Ontario Breaking Championship. So again, Saturday, May 26th, 2018, is the tournament. You must register and order all material by April 26th via the USBA website. We will have links posted in the description below as well as on various websites and pamphlet and flyer that will be passed around. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to contact me at 905-373-0032 or contact me via my USBA WBA email. It's jfield@usbawba.com. That's the easiest way to contact me, or if you're one of my students, you can just contact me when you come into class. We're going to make sure that everybody's going to have a blast at this tournament. This is the premier tournament in Canada as far as breaking goes. If you are a breaker, you want to be here. We get competitors from across Ontario. We got guys from Massachusetts, Connecticut. We had Indiana and Virginia and a few other states. Trying to think of some of the other ones that we have. This is a big tournament as far as the WBA goes. So we are really hoping to see everybody compete this year. We are looking forward to having some big numbers like we did last year. This is going to be a phenomenal tournament. So make sure you register at the link below or wherever the link may be from this video. And we'll see everybody on Saturday, May 26th. And we're going to have a phenomenal time. Thank you very much.